Welcome. You have found my treasure.
Welcome. Hi, everybody. Hi there, Scissors. How you doing? Sorry for the delay. I was just about to hit the start streaming button, and then somebody asked for help for something. Then I'm a very helpful person, so I did it. Whereas it ends up, he needs some other documents to scan in that he can't even find right now, so it all could have waited, but whatever. He didn't know that at the time, and I didn't know that, so it is what it is. Alright, so hello, this is Derail Valley. office. Haven't streamed for a while, I'm out of practice. Actually, I'm trying to. The big reason why I'm streaming today is that I'm trying to keep myself awake. Because I'm trying to get myself out of this funk of sleeping at the day, and then, you know, I'm awake, and I'm like, oh, I could stream now, but it's like 3 in the morning, and it's like, yeah, that's dumb. So, also, we're going to be running the radio today, and I am playing, we can thank David for this. David112, he's the one that I've been playing a little bit of this with the multiplayer. We did it a few times and it kind of works, but also he wanted to get this Chill Hop station, which is royalty free, and it's on YouTube. It's like a stream on YouTube, but that link didn't work for the radio, so he asked on the Derail Valley Discord, and long story short, somebody had a link for him, so we figured out how to add it to our radio list. And on top of that, I also added a, it's supposed to be a royalty-free jazz station, so I might switch it up. Only thing is, this is kind of quiet. Yeah, all I have to do is tune to the wrong station. Yeah, see, that's the wrong station. That's not allowed. Thankfully, there's ads on the stations with copyright music, so I won't get in trouble immediately. There's the public domain jazz. I might switch to that eventually. But for now, we got the chill hop and lo-fi hip hop, I think that stands for. Which doesn't bother me because it doesn't sound like hip-hop anyway, so that's good. Things that usually sound like hip-hop, I don't usually like hip-hop much or rap, but this is nice. I've listened to it before, like in the background. Alright, so what are we doing today? You know, I had my stream idea set up and everything ready to go, and then had some last minute things. So first off, I opened up OBS, and OBS wanted to update, and of course Stream Elements wanted to update at the same time. They were both trying to update at the same time, which means one was working and the other didn't. I had to restart OBS like 3 or 4 times to get it all working again. That was a little silly, and I had to sign into Twitch again and get my Authy app up. The authenticator thing. You know, I only use that for like Twitch and Nexus. Everything else I've used the smartphone for. Well, is he to sleep? Yeah. It is good for that. Yep. But I wanted, I don't know, the radio out there. I wanted to use the radio instead of my playlist for a change. I know the volume's not going to be all over the place with this. That's the thing. Unfortunately, it is pretty quiet still. Cranking it, I've got it cranked up to 10 now, and it's still kind of quiet. It's annoying. If I turn up the game more, then it's just going to make the train louder. We don't need that. Yeah, if you want, I'd be really into finding other like radio stations like this that I could play on that thing. The only thing it's for Derail Valley, because it's this really neat feature that you can have this boombox thing and carry it around with you, and then set it down and walk away, and it gets quieter. You go through a tunnel and it. And turns into static, that kind of thing. That's the advantage of doing that instead of playing it like in Media Player or whatever. Actually, Media Player, I kind of want to get away from using Media Player because sometimes it just causes a lot of lag when it goes from one song to the next now. I don't know why. It never did before. I don't know if it's because I just added more music or what, but like maybe the playlist is getting too big. But I want to be able to have all the music. I gotta take another shot at the Groove music player thing and see if I can make a new playlist from scratch and just have everything in it. But if I remember correctly, when I was trying to do that with Groove, it just kept, like, you'd get to a certain point and then it, like, would save the playlist and then you couldn't add anything else. It was just really annoying me. Like, when I first rebuilt the computer and everything, set up Windows 10, I had the Groove thing set up. I'm like, okay, this is, like, the new thing that's supposed to replace Media Player. You know, it came with Windows 10, so it must be better. So I tried really hard to use that, and I did for a while, but when I wanted to keep adding to the playlist, that's when I had trouble. For a while, what I was doing is I would load up the playlist in Media Player, add the songs in Media Player, because I could figure that out easily enough. Oh, I didn't turn the engine around. I'm an idiot. We can do it with the Y here, I guess. Indecision. I forgot I gotta turn around. But then after a while, maybe when the playlist got too big, I don't know. But all of a sudden, I would add songs to the playlist in Media Player, and then I would load up the playlist in Groove like I've always done before, and it wouldn't show the extra songs that I just added. So, I don't know if there's a limit to how long the playlist can be, or if something changed and it didn't like using the playlist for Media Player anymore. I don't know. It was all very bizarre. I need to find some other Media Player type free program. The other option is VLC, but the problem with the VLC one is every time that it plays any song on that playlist, it puts, I could have sworn I put the support. It puts the folder that the song's in my recent folders in the documents folder thing on Windows. I don't know why it does that. Like, you right click the documents icon on the taskbar, it'll bring up your recent folders. I use that all the time for actual folders that are, no, what's it called? It's not called recent, it's called, it's gonna bug me now. Frequent. Okay, so I have a bunch of files and folders that I use all the time, like the different screenshots, folders, the save game data for Derail Valley, because I have to switch out the save games all the time. You know, that kind of thing. But when I play songs on VLC, for some stupid reason, it puts, every time it plays any song in VLC, it puts the folder that that song came from in that frequent folders list. And it just knocks everything else out, and then you have to go and delete all of the new ones that just put in. And I'm like kind of anal about organizing all my music. So the music's in all these different folders, so I just have all these new folders in that frequent list just because I played the playlist on the VLC. Drives me absolutely nuts. So, and that's like a Windows thing, so it's not like it's something I can change. Although I don't know why VLC would do that. The other music players don't. Oh, I didn't go far enough. Good job. Too busy ranting. Oh, Harvest Moon and Rune Factory obsession, huh? Rune Factory. I think Iris just, I didn't watch it because I wasn't really interested in it, but I think Iris played that game on stream a couple nights ago. Rune Factory 5, that's the new one? I could tell it wasn't really for me, that kind of game. It's kind of like, Harvest Moon meets some other role-playing game, I would think. I remember now what people were saying it was like. I'll beat 3 and going through 4 right now. Oh. Yeah, okay, it's like a farming sim. It's like anime farming sim kind of thing. Yeah, it could be good. It might be one of those things that I was kind of afraid to watch because I don't want to get into it. Tame monsters who do a similar thing. Oh, that's cool. That's neat. So I've done all the switching and stuff in the here in the harbor off screen before I started streaming. Because, you know, that's probably kind of boring for you guys to watch anyway. And I put together a train, diesel and gasoline, and nitrogen going to food factory. So that's where we're going to go first. Oh, I was really late on that. We're right on the center track here. That's where I put the train together so that we'll leave all the switches to the main line when we leave town, which is good. And now that I've been downstairs for a little while, I went outside a couple of times, I went out to the car to look for stuff and whatnot. Now that I'm back up here in the room, it is friggin' hot in here. I got the fan on, I switched to my shorts. The chainmail on the back of this headpiece is actually nice and cool on my neck a little bit. It's nice. I think it would make me hotter, but I don't think it does. Almost tempted to attempt to open a window in here, but it's such a pain in the ass to get to the window, first off. And second of off, it's hard to explain, but just the way this room is, upstairs, up very close to the roof and attic, the opening the windows doesn't help much. It's like you don't even feel it. It's still just as hot. There's like maybe a sweet spot, like this time of year, spring, where you can open the windows and get something out of it, but it's usually not even worth it to even bother with the windows. It's usually as soon as it starts getting hot, you just get the stupid air conditioner in the window, but I can't put the air conditioner in yet. I'll get all sorts of yelled at. Summer's coming, yeah. I'd love to go to bed until next winter. I hate summer. I hate it, hate it, hate it. It's too damn hot. I did not start the job yet, so I don't know why I'm moving. I guess just to make sure everything's rolling fairly. So we've got 721 tons, by the way. 490 of diesel and gasoline. And 231 of nitrogen, so that's pretty much on the limit for what I can get out of the harbor with, because this is a steep hill getting out of here. Probably like 750 would be the most I would try. Well, we're moving free, but I'm gonna let me get the radio, because if I go all the way back there, it might be too far away and it'll stick it in the lost or found. I'm just double checking that everything's hooked up right. Pretty sure it is. We're rolling and I barely gave it any throttle. But, you know. Doesn't hurt to double check. Yeah, that's good. all-night gaming session. Nice. I've been doing all-night gaming sessions, but that's because my sleep schedule's been so screwed up lately. Just making sure all the handbrakes are on. Really, that tiny bit of handbrake? No. I don't have the throttle on at all right now, so she's just freewheeling. Okay, we're all good. What game? Train Sim World? Or Train... Yeah, there's Train Sim World. There's a couple of them that you play. We have 47 minutes, so that should be pretty good. One I just bought Hazmat 2, by the way. I only had one. The nitrogen needs Hazmat 2. The only licenses I'm missing right now is Hazmat 3. And I haven't done any of the military stuff, so 1, 2, 3 military. Oh, and the DE6. I don't have the DE6 license yet. I don't even know I'm gonna bother with it because Steam is king. Clips I'm inserting into my gun. Oh, nice. I'm gonna switch shovels because we're going uphill, so I'm gonna need a lot of heat. That's just faster. When I know I want that firebox full, I use the bigger shovel. Have you tried Derail Valley yet? I know you were thinking about it. An hour under my belt by the time we go around that curve and hit the hill. I'm that low on Steam? Really? But I had the fire going pretty hot. I dropped the throttle person. This might be a false start here. I use up that much steam. It must have been low when I started and I didn't even notice. Whatever you get in the mood for. I cycle between some games. Like, I haven't played Minecraft for months, and maybe within the last week or so I've been starting to pick it up again. Not the modded world. I didn't get into the modded world yet, but I've been playing vanilla. But I almost streamed that today, but I was already putzing around in Derail Valley, so you had to stick with it. Well, I have a feeling this room wouldn't be quite as hot if I wasn't playing Derail Valley, though. This game makes my computer work a bit harder. I mean, it handles it fine, but I think I do notice the room gets a little hotter when I play this game. Speed or fire. How hot are we? That's pretty good. You might think I'm overdoing it with that much heat, but just wait till we hit this hill. Static is plenty loud enough. That ain't gonna happen. One good thing is you can't overfill the firebox, as far as I can tell. Like, if it's already full of cobble. Of coal, and you throw another shovel of coal in there, it just goes back in the tender. I don't know how that really works. It's kind of magical like that, but you know the devs were nice enough to not screw you over quite that much. Well, we're only doing 20, but we're making it so far, knock on wood. I've got the draft open full. So it's burning through the coal as fast as it can, pretty much. We got the temp up just into the red, but that's the only thing that's keeping me from running out of steam right now, because I've got the throttle almost full open. Yes. Glad I made myself stream today, because I was kind of, I was getting into a funk kind of thing, like if I'm not super awake anyway, and I'm like, I don't need to stream, blah blah blah, but I gotta make myself stream sometimes, but I never regret streaming, so that's good. Gotta kick myself a little bit sometimes into gear. There we go. Okay, we're doing pretty good. This is 721 tons, and I got a little worried, especially in the beginning when I didn't have any... I was half out of steam before I started for some reason, because I wasn't paying attention. Okay, I'm actually going to throttle for a little bit. Just for a little bit, because we're still going uphill, so... I don't know if the back half of the train is in a 30 zone or 25 zone. I usually just stick with 25 coming up here. It's a long train. good steam engine. Hi there, Dark Vino, how you doing? You've been working on the railroad. Candle on the floor. Oh, this is the boombox. That's where the music's coming from. And now it's out because we're in the tunnel. All right, get back in the swing of the streaming. I've been kind of slacking off a little bit lately. L-shaped handle. Oh, this. That's the draft. When it's down, it's all the way open, which makes the fire burn hotter, but also burns through the coal a lot faster. Usually you don't need it, but I'm climbing this mountain. Actually, I still need it. Climbing the mountain, so I need a lot of steam right now. Almost up over the crest of the hill, just about. The worst of it is definitely over now. Pick up speed now. Pick up a little bit too much speed. Now we're good. Yeah, kind of, yep. I think the draft, I'm not sure if it opens up, like, right under the firebox, or if it, like, goes through the whole locomotive. I'm not sure how that works, but, yeah, it just adds more air to the fire, basically. Okay, that's over 45 now. Hi there, Lambda. Rawr. Okay, now I can close the draft. Usually you want to keep the draft closed just so you don't burn through as much coal, but sometimes I need a lot of heat. We're hauling 721 tons, and that was a pretty big climb that just came up. Checking over right now. also going to switch my shovel back. I'm going to put this back over here. That's the regular standard shovel. Two scoops with that fills up the firebox. Now I'm going to use the smaller one, which takes, I think, 6 scoops to fill it. The advantage to that, as I've discovered, slow down a bit, is if you're not putting in as much coal, you're keeping the firebox a little bit cooler, then you don't use up as much water. It's all about fuel management. Temperature management, I should say. And when I was going up the hill, I needed all the coal in there I could get. But now that we're going down, all I have to do is maintain the steam. I can let it get cooler. A little fast, but it's okay. It's not that fast. A lot of these 35 mile per hour signs for the switches, it's kind of more of an extra safeguard. I think you could probably go through them at like 40. I mean, I just went through that last one at 40 and it was fine. I guess it depends on the switch sometimes. 35. Yeah, we're doing a little over 30. I've got a mod running that switches all the signs from, and the speedometer, from kilometers per hour to miles per hour, because I'm very American. I gotta have my miles. Of course, I played it with kilometers for a while because the mod to switch it to miles just came out pretty recently. So I had to kind of retrain myself with the speeds, but still glad I did it. That bell ringing means that the firebox is getting under 200 Celsius, so it's getting cool. But we're just freewheeling downhill right now, so I don't really mind it getting too cool right now. Try to make up for all the coal and water we just used up getting up the mountain. Okay, now I need to slow down. Okay, I had to check that switch. We're good. Going up to food factory. Going a little fast, maybe, but not too bad. I know the spots where I gotta be more careful. Like that 30 sign, it doesn't really have to be quite that slow. It's just kind of a standard yard speed, but steel mill has a dead straight track going through the middle. So the switches are lined good. I don't know why I just stood up there. Can really fly it through here a lot faster than 30. Just a touch of the brakes, just a little bit, because we're going downhill again. There's the engine house where you first start the game. Fortunately, you never use it again after you start. slow back down to 35 or 40 anyway, so no point in speeding up. Actually, that's a 50. That's the one that doesn't last, right? Train. I can see it a little bit better there. Sixty is pretty much the highest these speed limits get. There's a couple spots that go up to 75, but it's a very short section of track that goes up to 75, so there's really never any point to get that high. Even here it was 60 for about 100 feet, now it's back down to 40 for 55. Probably could have gotten another two scoops there. Although that curve in particular, even if you're doing like 40 and a 45, it makes the wheels make the grinding noise and makes the I'm about to derail noise, but it never does. It's a little weird, that one spot. I mean, the game's called Derail Valley for a reason. I had a little derailment yesterday, I think it was. I was coming the other direction around this area, a little bit further up. This switch is fine. Right? I think I came down from the food factory, so this should all be set. We're not there yet. But I thought it was in a 45, and I thought I was under 45, but I was a little bit over. It's a little tricky because since the game was designed with kilometers an hour, 35 in kilometers would be 60. And when it's in kilometers, the vanilla basically without the mods, then it's just one digit. You just add the zero afterwards on the signs. So since I'm trying to deal with fives with the miles per hour, yeah, the switch is fine. I have to kind of guess, like, you know, right now we're doing about 32. Also, my eyes aren't the best, so. Yeah. Hi there, Sturgy, how you doing? Finally got to streaming. It was delayed for a while because I had to do some fiddling stuff, long story short. First OBS was being a pain in the ass and wanting to update, and then Stream Elements had to update, and then it crashed. got that sorted out, and then somebody needed some documents scanned in, because I'm the only one that knows how to use the printer, so that was another little bit of delay. Oh, cool. Of a hill this is. Normally you don't really think of this section as much of a hill, but it actually is. And I really needed to hit that with more speed. Oh, we might stall out. Damn it. Like, when you're coming up from the harbor, it's very obvious that you're coming up a big hill. This hill really sneaks up on you. I'm gonna switch shovels again because that took a while. Open up the draft. Doesn't last too long. It's not nearly as bad as trying to climb out of the food factory, though. That's really steep hill. Yeah, if I had a bit more speed, I would have been fine, I think. But now we're gonna struggle. Okay. Once we cross this bridge coming up and go through the switch and cross the bridge, then it'll go to downhill and it'll be smooth sailing. But right now we're climbing. I think I can. Oh, it's freaking hot in here. I might have to switch games. It's too hot. 75 degrees in my room. Too damn early for this crap. Just had rain for like 2 days straight. The whole backyard's all flooded out practically. It was cool with the rain. Now it's hot. Oh, that sounds good. I think we're up to the steepest part of the hill. And downhill, so pretty soon I'm gonna be able to lay off the throttle completely. Actually, I'm gonna already close the draft. We'd be good now. All the way down here to Food Factory, the speed limit's pretty low. Even this 30 is going to drop right back down to 25. I'm just going to ride the brakes all the way down there now. Would have been 30 in kilometers, 25 is 40. Let me see what my deficit. Oh, not to that. Music. Oh, thank you. When I've got the playlist going, I can use that. I'll add to it. I used to be real big into my records. Then I went digital, and I still liked the records, but I didn't get around to playing them much. But I had a really nice hi-fi that I played them on back at the other house. But I never made it to this house. I brought the records with me, but I never was able to move the hi-fi here. And you know that Crosley record player that I have now. But I also lost a lot of my records in the big flood that we had. God, that was like 8 years ago now, but it's going to be in our memories the rest of our lives. I mean, really, compared to other places, the flooding around here wasn't as bad, but we lost a lot of stuff. Because we had stuff stored on, like, the floor in the garage, or the floor in the basement, or maybe only, like, a couple inches off the floor in the basement, and we got, like, 4 feet of water in the basement. And that was with the drain open. Yeah, it really sucked. And the crazy thing was, this area has never flooded before that. Like my grandparents bought this house in 1957. They've never once had a flood. Not from the brook, anyway. How fast am I going? I left that on the wrong page. Neat. Oh, vinyl to MP3. Cool. Go. Oh, we're here and I didn't check where we're going. B2, C6. C6, good. Oh, crap, that was turned. Who left that switch turned? I'm glad David's not here. He'd be all over me for that one. Now I gotta back up. I don't have to back up too far. Up to the crossing there. Oh, yeah. I got that, Sturgy. I got that, I think, last night. I checked Twitch Prime Gaming. Yeah, for GOG. Yep, I picked it up for free. I don't know if I'll ever play it, but it was free, so I grabbed it. Yeah. Not until Skyrim, I think, when you have to worry about which version it is and what it's compatible with, because, well, Skyrim is when they really started just making all different editions and versions and making people have to buy it over and over again. I don't think that's really much of a thing with Oblivion yet. I don't know. I could be wrong. Is Black Desert free to play? Like that style game where it's free to play, but if you want certain things, you have to buy them. You know, like Lord of the Rings Online or D&D Online. I can't believe I left that switch thrown. Usually I leave these switches set to straight. When you're coming into a food factory like that though, there's too much that you have to do all at once with the switches. Oh, okay. I'll check it out, Black Desert. I've heard of that a few times. Now I'm kind of going downhill a little bit. So let's see, 6. Oh, crap. Wait, what's in the front? The front is the tankers. Oh, okay, so I'm gonna have to go up and back the tankers over to D2. Usually that's a little bit better than the other way around. Also, the problem is the fan that I have running is up on top of the computer, blowing on me. But a lot of the heat is coming from the computer. I mean, it's also because it's, you know, 70 degrees outside, so it's hot in the room anyway, but the heat, the computer does pump out some heat. Oh, hey there, Lizard. How you doing? Haven't seen you around in a while. What day is today? It's today Friday. I don't think so. Oh, yeah, it is Friday. I'm good with days. Today is Friday. Okay, good. I figured you've been really busy. Yeah. How am I doing on time, actually? Because I could turn in the first one. I've got lots of time still. Or did I ever set it? I never set it. Okay, never mind. I don't know how I'm doing on time, so let me turn in the one that I just... hot dogs. Don't ask me why, but yes, we have hot dogs. I didn't think that car was actually going to show up as a job, but it does. Let's see. Oh, 39 minutes and they gave me 47. Okay, we still got good. Somebody, it's the silliest mod that I've ever added to this game yet, and I don't know if I'm going to keep it, but somebody, and they didn't even announce it on the Discord, on the Derail Valley Discord like they usually do with mods, but somebody, they linked like a GIF of this train of hot dogs going through like a subway tunnel or something. And so they said, so I decided to make a hot dog car. This is a joke. The silliest thing is that hot dog car is technically a box car. And in this game, they haven't made specifically livestock cars yet. Livestock just is in box cars, so like... So the first time I saw that hot dog car pop up as a job, I don't know what was in that one, I didn't check. But the first time was in the farm, and apparently that hot dog car was loaded up with cows. Okay. Yeah, put the cows in the hot dog. Yeah, we're skipping a step. Nice. We're going uphill there, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to let it get coast. Let's try it. That's why they call it a firebox. Advanced tactics. Blowing the air from the other end to set the brakes. Now it's going to start rolling back downhill, but that's the way I want to go anyway, so it's fine. Oh, that switch was thrown. I was really bad last time I was here, leaving the switches in bad positions. Disc, disc. I want track 2 here. Which one's track 2? Oh, dead center. That's nice. Yeah, well, you can actually, you can just hit a number and put it on your belt, but she's rolling down the hill now, but, I kind of like the added, little, I don't even know if you'd call it a challenge, but, just something that you have to keep fiddling with the radio. Get water here in the fire and the food factory, so I hope I didn't screw that up. Elden Ring, yeah, I figured. That is the hot game of the year so far. It does look really good. Yeah. Yep, you and Lambda have been playing it a lot, probably. lot of the VTubers are playing it. Everybody's playing it. And I don't blame them. It looks really freaking good. Yeah. I love that Scarlet Rot. Watching Callie play it a little bit this morning. Freaking hot dogs. What's in here? Bread. Well, it's the bun of the hot dog. Oh, wow. So the player gets to do the Scarlet Rot stuff too, huh? Oh, yeah, I bet. Okay, 2 minutes to spare. Hey, how much do we think? 38,000. I didn't even check the sheet for the first one that we brought in, how much that was worth, but at any rate, we have, and I just spent like 120 grand before I left the harbor. We have 349,000 right now. Not bad. And the other thing that I heard was kind of cheap in Elden Ring is bleed damage. Probably not as cheap as the Scarlet Rot stuff though. Let's see, there's the unload of the two jobs that we just brought in. This one's kind of, well, it's kind of worth it. I'll have to decide depending on how much water I have left in the tender. Bleed is way cheaper. Oh. Okay. Machine factory. What is that? Iron ore mine west. That's towards machine factory, okay. All my people across the globe, if you know a jealous. Oh, that's the custom cars too. Oh, I heard a bad word. It's factory, that's not going to be worth much of anything. That's not worth it. That's not worth it either. Doing paperwork. Oh, sawmill. Guess that's not going to be worth much of anything now. It's just a couple empties. Steel mill. I can't really go to sawmill from here unless I went the long way through the iron mine so they could refill the tender.
You're listening to Chill Sky Radio, lo-fi hip-hop, and
Arbor. Good fact, empty container.
Chill Hop Beats 24/7. Support Chill Sky and become a Patreon. Donating $1 makes a difference.
Yeah, Goods Factory.
Visit chillsky.com.
Really isn't worth much.
Or via Instagram at
Steel Mill. Oh. Scrap metal, that's gonna be really heavy. Oh wow, 870, that's definitely no way in hell am I making it out of here with 870 tons. If it was flat ground, I could, but not out of food factory. By the way, if you notice, my voice sounds a little funny. I still don't have my my new crowns on my front teeth. Did get a confirmation for the dentist, so I think like Tuesday. I think Mom said Tuesday, Monday, somewhere between Monday and Wednesday. I'm gonna go and finally get the crowns fitted in, and then I shouldn't be lisping anymore. I don't even really care what they look like, but I didn't think of the lisping. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Bleed, rot, poison character. Cool. Oh, and you did strength. Strength, faith. Nice. There's the teeth, yeah. Okay, I guess I'll take the, oh, I never threw this in the caboose, whoops. I'm gonna do both these unload jobs. Grab on both, but... Let me look at the tender and see how much water we have. That's kind of the first thing to check. That was a... We had a couple of real rough spots getting out of the harbor and then getting up to here. Where I had to really throw in a lot of coal. Oh. 1, 2... Not even 3 full bars down. Wow. I still saved a lot of fuel in a lot of places. I thought that was going to be like halfway down. Neat. It's not too bad then. Maybe I'll do both unload jobs. Did I unhook this yet? Oh, good. Don't unhook it because I'll just... Yes, it uses the... You're the second or third person to notice that so far, and I didn't notice it because I almost never played Half-Life. I played it a little bit, but not enough to recognize it. Yeah, this is the, it's called the Nightlight mod. Don't really need it now because I'm not running the procedural sky or day-night, so it never gets dark. But every once in a while, I do need a light on something. And yes, it uses the sound effect. kind of funny. Okay, I'm gonna shove this back through and then pull it up onto the loading track. Try to be like Mr. Pickles. Daddy Fat Tax, B-I-G-B-O-I is that same motherfucker that took them knuckles to your eye and I tried to warn you. You know, I know this Chill Hop station has hip-hop in the title, but I've listened to it for a while before, and it didn't really sound like hip-hop. I used to, I wonder, I'm like, why does this say hip-hop? Now it sounds like hip-hop. Now I'm hearing the hip-hop words. I didn't think there was lyrics on this thing. I guess it depends. Maybe I'll switch it to the jazz station. I have 2 royalty-free stations. I have the Chill Hop. Yeah, this one. Public Domain Jazz. See what that's like. That's quiet, too. It's too quiet. Yeah. I didn't blow the whistle for the crossing, oh well. And this, I'm worried about whether or not it's actually copyright. It's supposed to be copyright free from the website that... We'll find out. That big a deal. Bali high will whisper on the wind of the sea. Did I hit the brakes that hard? I didn't think I did. Well, this is nice. I hope it's not copyrighted though. I guess I could fire up my media player and go back to my music, but... Media player's been lagging on me a lot lately.
the hillside and shine in the streams. If you try, you'll find where the sky.
But my neighbor would like this music. I'm going to stream for, what time is it now? Almost 4, 6. I'll stream for another maybe hour. Because they're probably outside because it's really nice and warm out today. But I got to go over there because I got to set up Facebook on their computer, on their laptop. One thing I forgot to do yesterday when I was over there. This is music. I don't know, but I know. Oh, there's the new mail cart. Not mail. Refrigerator box store. First time it showed up. Cool. There's a lot of custom cars now. There's another one. I think it has a couple of skins, too. A couple different colors it could be. Fallout? Yeah, I guess it kind of does, huh? Let's make sure we're completely on the loading track. Oh yeah, yeah, we're good. I'm gonna move the engine over to the other end though, because it might make me put a couple of empties on that one track that you can only access from that end. They love to do that. Gotta reclose this. So many times I forget to close this and then I'm at the other end and I'm like, why aren't the cars airing up? Well, because you left the angle cock open, doofus. Part of this stream is just me trying to keep myself awake, too. So I've been sleeping daytime lately, and that's the main reason why I haven't streamed much. I don't think I will. I guess there's a lot of jazz, even with vocals, that's fine. I miss the days when you didn't have to worry about that. Still playable. Twitch VOD I want to be able to work. Yeah, yeah, claiming revenue, I don't care. It's when it gets blocked or muted. The only thing that I have any kind of potential of making money with is Twitch. Oh, this one's a little louder. I almost got worried for a second that there were cars sitting on the loading track. Yeah, I think my brain's starting to maybe get a little scarlet rot or something. Of course there's cars on the track, I just parked them there. These tankers are full of gasoline and diesel, so do be careful hooking up to them, because they will go boom pretty easily, actually. It's a little silly how easily they go boom. Forgetting to put this license in here unless I make a separate trip for it. That's bad. Oh, come on. So finicky. There you go. Gotta store away my paperwork. Most people just junk those licenses as soon as they buy them, because you don't need them at all. Did I start the job yet? Like I said, brain rot is sitting in. I did not start the job yet. Oh, this one's in another language. Shouldn't get copyrighted then, right? Nobody, it sounds like Italian. Oh, it's all going to see. Oh. Okay. I'm glad I gave myself the head start of parking it on the loading track at a time, because I probably only got like 9 minutes. Crazy. It was cold enough, I think, last night for the heat to kick on a few times. now it's like 75 degrees in my room. Yeah. I went back, I was checking on, the brook that runs behind my house, well, a little ways back there in the woods, and, they upgraded the brook, they kind of rebuilt it, made it a lot wider, and a little bit deeper, I think, too. So that it should never be able to flood again like it did like 8 years ago or whatever it was. And it was probably pretty close to the highest I've ever seen it since they rebuilt it. Still not dangerous levels yet. It's like halfway, which means that it can still hold a lot more water, but it was pretty high. Just from usually it's almost dry because it's kind of like runoff from other reservoirs and stuff. Okay, I'm just gonna leave that there. I thought I went back far enough and I did not. Oh no, now we're rolling the wrong way. At least they're empty now. Good. Overwinter your chili plant. Oh, cool. Oh, that's cool. I never had much of a green thumb. I never really cared to, really. My grandpa used to do a lot of gardening and stuff. And I got too far away from the radio, I guess. Great. It's back in Lost and Found. That was right. 9? 9. That's gonna be all the way over, right? Yeah. There's the radio. Hi there, interweb person, how you doing? We're just, brought up, 720 tons of, fuel. Well, this part's the fuel that I'm unloading now. And we also did nitrogen. The whole train was 720 tons. Should probably put it in forward, huh? Oh yeah, I can totally see what's going on. Oh no, I missed a switch. Second time I've missed the switches. At least they're empty. I'm not gonna get the time bonus on this one though. I was just back there looking at the switches and I still missed it. Just like a vanished love I can't forget. Oh, cool. I can't really hear handle spices too good. Jalapenos, nice. Oh, you made chili powder too. Oh, that's cool. let the water get a little loaded. Uh-huh. Oops. Thankfully, steam engines can't explode yet. I think they will after the next update, though, if you let the water get too low. Dry up fruits and grind them into powder. So, yeah, I guess that makes sense, but it's something you never really think of. Might be kind of an American thing, too, to just not realize that chili powder actually comes from chilies. I can't believe I missed those switches. I was standing right next to them. Right. That's cool. There wasn't anything parked on this track, right? I'm pretty sure there wasn't. Brain is not working too good today. No, we're clear. Good. This is kind of one of the problems with the steam engine, is you can't see squat. Well, I never bought the remote control for the diesels yet, so I'm just as worse, just in bad shape running switching with the diesels. Well, you can see a bit better with the diesels, but still something like that seeing far away. Yeah. I got something better than forward revisibility. There's your reverse revisibility. Too far. I hope I didn't go too far. Well, let's see if we can turn it in. Gotta have our jazz then. Stand by. Okay. Oh, exactly 10 minutes. We got the speedy bonus. Yep. Just barely. That was because I got all the cars on the loading track before I started the job. Oh. Yeah. That makes sense. Yeah. Southern Pacific Railroad here in the States back in the day, towards the later stages of steam, they designed cab-forward steam engines. They were big, articulated steam engines. Not too much smaller than, like, the big boys. I don't remember what wheel arrangements they were. But they closed in the cab of the steam engine and put the tender on the other end and ran cab-forward. They had to because the line was full of tunnels and snow sheds and stuff. And the smoke would choke them out if they had the smoke in front of them. So it worked out good, but of course with a cab forward you can only run diesel. You can't burn coal. Because the tender's in the wrong place. Alright, let's have a good meal. Yeah, I don't know how much. I think I've got maybe an hour. And then I gotta stop and run next door. Wanted to start a little earlier, but that didn't work out too good. Yeah, probably. Yeah, I don't know what kind of oil they burned back in the day for their cab overs, cab forwards, cab over. I'm thinking of trucking now. Oh, I should set some handbrakes. Don't need to set handbrakes, but I should because I have the handbrake mod, so might as well use it. Yeah. I know. Oh, what was it? The big turbine, gas turbine engines that you Union Pacific replaced the big boys with. Those burned. I think it was called Bunker C fuel oil, and it was like really thick, like almost tar. And they had to preheat it just for it to get into the engine. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Then I guess as soon as they started using it, then, you know, supply and demand, when they started using it, it was probably super cheap to buy that stuff. And then it went up, and then it wasn't so cheap anymore. Probably. Come on, that's not open enough. Okay, and now I gotta unload the other set of the train that I brought in here with the caboose there. Game's getting a little laggy here and there. How's my temperature? So I'm gonna check my core temp real quick. Is it even running? It's not even running. Hold on. Yeah. Celsius, it's a little high. It's not dangerous, but yeah. 56, 52, 56. I might switch games. This game is maybe heating things up a little too much. It's because the room's so hot, too. I'm gonna go to sleep. Wake me up on Christmas. Wake me up for winter. Oh, wow, this song. It's supposed to be copyright free. I think it'll be okay. Keeps raining all the time. How did I hear this song? Life is bare. Gloom and misery everywhere. Stormy weather. Episode of In the Heat of the Night, maybe? Man, some show that I was watching. Somebody was singing this song. Yeah, it should be public domain because it's really old, yeah. Oh, I read something about that, the last coal mine. Shut. I'm guessing it's going to cost a fortune to bring in, like, maybe American coal, because shipping it overseas and everything. Oh, that sucks. I guess they're not really using coal power plants over there anymore. So they got rid of the only coal mines. A lot of preserved steam here in the U.S. they've converted to oil. Because it's just easier. Boy, you do miss that coal. I Oh, wow. Switch games. I didn't want to. I'm noticing this is getting a little laggy. The temperatures are starting to get a little high. I believe it. Did I leave the frickin' angle cock open? I did. Give me the radio. I'd be more worried about the dynamite than the hands. Yeah, dynamite blows up. At least hands don't blow up. Oh god. That's bad. Wait, what? No? Did I not just close it? Did it lag out and I closed it and then opened it again? It's closed. Did it open up somewhere else? It did. How did that happen? That's interesting. I've seen that happen with cars that just spawned in. I've never seen it happen on a train that I brought in. Wow. That's really weird. Hose randomly disconnected back here. The coupler's still coupled. Huh. Very strange. Maybe something to do with the coupler mod. I love those knuckle couplers, though. Don't leave home without them. Now we're airing up. Cold dust compacts. Compressed back down, man. Ugh. Then, I think I read somewhere, was it Ireland? Used to run their steam engines with, peat? Is that what it's called? Not sure what peat is. But that is probably very dirty, too. Yeah. I think this is lagging out too much. Oh, okay. Wow. I That's gotta leave a lot of byproduct. Oh, yeah, I guess I could see that happening. Oops. The FRA is not watching. Like 78 degrees in the room now. I think I'm gonna have to switch games. This game is too hot. I mean, also, it's just hot in the room in general, but still, the computer's pumping out a lot of heat right now. Everything's working fine, nothing's like in danger of melting down or anything like that, but. Video card's doing good. It's still at the same temperature it's always at, 50, sometimes 52 Celsius, but that's still fine. Stop streaming, actually. After I unload these. I'm gonna stream as long as I wanted to then, but. Good things to cool off. Oh, OBS is not up, I think. Oh, thanks for the follow. Yeah, I play Derail Valley a lot. I gotta get my steering wheel set back up and do some trucking. I haven't done that in a while. But I should. Bunch of different truck games they play too, not just American Truck Simulator, but a bunch of the older ones too. Three drop-offs. That's kind of annoying. Oh well. You know what? I think I'm not even gonna do that now. I just think my temps are getting a little too high.
And when is Christmas?
And I gotta run next door anyway. Alright. That's it for the stream, I think. Wish I started earlier now that I knew that I have to end earlier. Didn't work out too good. Oh, I gotta get some music going.
Welcome.
Okay. Kind of stopping abruptly a bit here, but my computer's getting a little too hot. I might try to crack a window open, but man, it doesn't make much of a difference up here when I open the windows. But, let's see, how long did I go? What? Apparently I've been offline for 12 days, 15 hours. Okay. Oh, I guess I have to update something with the stream elements then. Oh yeah, there it is on OBS. Well, almost 2 hours. That's better than nothing. A lot of people showed up today. That was nice.
That was a heroic.
Got a couple of new follows, I think. Cool. Well, that was fun. Let me just see if anybody else is streaming that I would raid. Somebody that I kind of know at least. Nope. So thanks for showing up, and I'm going to try to get to streaming a bit more often. Next time will probably be, probably Minecraft. Because I am getting back into Minecraft. Probably not World of Warcraft, because I don't have WoW time anymore, so I have been playing WoW a little bit here and there, but it's kind of annoying when you can only go up to level 20. Although you can keep questing and stuff and making money and getting reps, so. So yeah, I'll see you guys around later. Bye.
Ha ha ha!